Imagine writing your first book and it becoming an international bestseller. That's exactly what happened to Chigoze Obioma, set in his hometown of Kure in southwest Nigeria, and telling the story of four brothers, it cemented Chigoze's reputation as one of the most exciting young writers around. The Fisherman was a global hit, being translated into 24 languages. It's even been adapted into a play, which we featured here on What's New in November.
It was one of the most surreal moments of my life so far. It's amazing to have been in the audience and, you know, watch, you know, people react in these ways.
So 4 years on from his first book, he's back.
The children, what are they? From whence had they come?
Has following up the first book got him feeling the pressure?
I can't help myself. I'm always working on a lot of things at the same time. So I'm like the millipede with the many hands. So yeah, even right now I have ideas swimming in my head. So because I was already working on these while The Fisherman was having its run, I didn't really feel that much pressure to change much.
Like The Fisherman, An Orchestra of Minorities is set partly in Nigeria. It follows the journey of Chinoso as he falls in love and struggles to adapt with moving to a new country. Written mainly in English with some Igbo and Pidgin thrown in, it's partly based on events in Chigoze's life. So, what's next in the pipeline?
Have you ever thought about writing a book aimed for children?
That's a good question. You know, I wrote one when I was 17. I keep toying with the idea of like revamping the text and rewriting it. I don't know when I would do that, but it's something that I'm thinking of, yeah.
And what was the first story you wrote? Do you remember it?
It was called The Dwarf King. It's a novel about this guy who is a dwarf and he rules over this country of like tall people.
I mean, I'd read that. Yeah. Sounds great. Yeah.
But I lost the manuscript sadly.
Oh, that's a shame. So it won't ever see the light of day.
No.
If there's a young person in Nigeria who has all these fantastic ideas and loves creative writing and wants to go and become an author and do what you've done and have the success that you've had, what advice would you give them?
Well, if that's what they want to do, then they should go ahead and do it. It will be challenging. Don't just, you know, once you encounter some kind of hindrance and then you just fall away, no. And you should read a lot. You know, it sounds like cliche, but you have to really read if you want to write.